Hi, I just wanted to come on here quickly and encourage all of you that might be at a place where you have to make decisions. It is so difficult to know what decision to make when we have big decisions on the table. And it's very hard to know when we are bombarded with voices that tells us which one would be the right decision. So, whether you're in a place where you have to make a decision on whether you want to buy a house or keep renting, maybe it is whether you should get the vaccine or not. Doesn't matter what it is. If you have a big decision to make and you don't know what is the right thing, I want to encourage you today to just think about two things. The first thing is fear. Is fear behind our decision making? Because it often is. Let's look at the example of the house buying. You might be scared that if you don't buy now, you're never going to get into the housing market. That's a fear-based decision. You might fear that for the rest of your life, you're going to be paying somebody else's mortgage by paying rent. That's fear-based right there again. So neither one of those two reasons would be the right decision, the right noise to allow you to make a decision. So what do we do then? Well, the word says, Romans 12, verse 2, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So what it says is you should not look at the housing market and you should not look at that for making your decision. We should look at those things to help us make a decision because God is given us brains and he's given people in our lives that can give us guidance and wisdom who's walked the roads before. And it's good to get that advice, but we should never have people's opinions or fear of what would happen if we don't do something, or fear if we do something, be the reason why we make a decision. So fear is the one thing. Check your heart. What is it? Are you scared of the vaccine, of what it can do to you, and that's why you don't want to get it? Or are you scared of COVID and that's why you want to get the vaccine? Neither one of those two things are right to be the reason why you get it. The only reason why you should get it is because you have peace in your heart. And that is the difference between being conformed to this world or being transformed by the renewing of your mind. So the one thing is fear. Fear should never be the reason. And the second thing is conformation by this world. So that means peer pressure. That means feeling that if you don't do this, people are not going to like you, or people are going to think weird about you. Or if you do it, somebody's going to be offended. And so then you don't do it because you don't want people to be upset. So you rather want to conform to the way they think and the way they do and what they would do so that you keep everybody happy. So do not be conformed to this world and do the things like the world does, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So if you have a big decision to make in your life, get quiet. Shut down all the noise. Shut the noise from the people around you. Shut the noise from, take the information and file it. You have that information now. Now get quiet and ask the Holy Spirit, what are you supposed to do for you with regards to that decision? Because what Sally is supposed to do about that is different than what you're supposed to do about that, because only you are you, and you've been called on your journey. And there is one person, I'm seeing one person joined us, Life Pilot is the name. I don't know who that is, but that just inspired me. That is your pilot. The Holy Spirit is your pilot that will steer you where you're supposed to go so that you can fly. So don't be fearful. Don't make any decision out of fear, and don't make any decision out of trying to please people because you're scared of people not going to like you or be offended. The Holy Spirit has the right answer for you for right now. Whether it's buying a house, whether it's whether you should or should not get the vaccine, doesn't matter what the big decision is you have to make. Big decision, take it to Jesus. Get quiet, ask the Holy Spirit to show you and to guide you. And then be courageous, because it's scary sometimes to do what we're called to do, especially if it goes against the flow of what everybody else is doing. But again, the Holy Spirit is with you. He's your comforter, but he's also your guide, and he wants to guide you in this.